Hi folks, and welcome to our OALabs series on YARA. Now, if you're seeing this, it's because you're watching this video on YouTube. So just a quick shill for our Patreon. If you like this kind of content, go check it out. With that, let's jump in. So we've put together a multi-part tutorial series talking about different aspects of YARA, how to use it, how we like to use it, different types of rules that you can build, and different ways that you can use the rules. So we've put this together in a series, and of course, we're not gonna be able to cover every aspect of YARA, but we do also include a bunch of links to further learning if you guys wanna dive in. So you might be wondering, why are we doing this series now? We've been around for a long time. We use YARA all the time. If you've caught our streams on Twitch, you know this. So why are we talking about YARA now? Well, this is the third year, I believe, that there is a very cool project that is running through Twitter, X pretty much, where a bunch of different people, anyone can join, will get together and share YARA rules for the first 100 days in the year. It's called 100 Days of YARA, and if you just search for the hashtag 100 Days of YARA on Twitter, X, then you can find all these different rules that people are putting out. There's lots of different ways that people are using and abusing YARA to make it do things that nobody ever intended it to do. I think it's a great project. We support it 100%. And it kind of inspired us to put together this tutorial series for those of you who may not be familiar with YARA or are just kind of getting started with YARA and want a few pointers. Also, a quick mention, in the series, we are going to be using our own platform, UNPACME, to be testing and developing YARA rules and to be hunting for malware with YARA. Of course, there are many other free open source platforms that you guys can use to try YARA, and we've included a few below the video if you want to try those out as well. We're just using our own because we like it, we built it, and it's free, so it's a good resource which anyone can use as long as you're using it non-commercially. Use it for work, you gotta pay. But otherwise, if you're using it for personal use, you can use it for free. So with that, let's get started. Okay, for our introduction to YARA, let's just provide a quick overview of what YARA is. Assuming you've never used YARA before and you're wondering, what is it and how can I use it? So basically, YARA is an open source tool. You can find it on GitHub here. You can compile it yourself or download one of the releases here. It runs on all platforms, Mac, Windows, and Linux. And it is essentially a pattern matching tool. So what you do is you write some rules. The rule syntax we're going to talk about in a minute is very intuitive. And then those rules can be run in the YARA tool to scan a directory or a file and identify matches for the rule. So it's sort of like an AV signature tool. If you think about old school antivirus where they had a bunch of signatures and they would run it on a host and identify malware. So YARA is an open source generic version of that sort of concept. Of course, you don't have to use YARA to search for malware, but that's generally what it's being used for. Now, the interesting thing about YARA is that it is an open source tool, but that tool has been integrated into many different EDR and antivirus platforms. In fact, I can't think of an EDR platform that doesn't support YARA. So what this means is that once you write a rule using the local tool, or if one of your colleagues or a researcher in our industry has shared a YARA rule, you can then use that YARA rule both locally in the YARA tool and most likely in your EDR product if it's supported. And again, I think every EDR product I've ever used has supported YARA. So it's basically an open source way to share rules that are matching on malware. And because there is a local version, you can run it locally on your own host or on your servers or whatever you want as a way to test and build rules. Also, YARA has become a search engine of sorts for malware hunting. Many malware repositories such as VirusTotal or ourselves, UNPACME, have a YARA search capability where you can upload a YARA rule and search the repository of malware for matches. If you're getting into threat intelligence or malware research, this is a very powerful tool for finding new malware or searching for different variants of a sample that you're looking at. It is, in fact, one of the most powerful tools that we have as malware analysts. So with that, what does this actually look like? Well, here we've downloaded the open source YARA binary for Windows. And if we run on the command line here, you can see it's asking for a rule file. So why don't we go ahead and create a simple rule that we can test locally, and I'll show you the different components of a rule. So if we open a text editor here, I'm using Sublime, and I've actually installed the YARA syntax highlighting for Sublime. Just makes it a bit easier to see the syntax. So we have our text editor here, and let's go over the core concepts of a YARA rule. The first part is the rule definition. So we have the rule keyword, then the name of the rule, no spaces in the name, and then open bracket and close bracket to contain the rule. Inside of the rule, there are three main sections. There's meta, which has metadata. These are key value pairs that you can add to describe the rule. You don't have to have a metadata section, but usually the author name and a short description of the rule are placed in the metadata section. Then we have a strings section. Now, strings is a bit misleading. Strings are both strings and patterns that are going to be found in the target file. So this is where you include strings, hex-encoded binary strings, or regular expressions for things that you want to match in the file. The string syntax is very straightforward, and there's almost a Pythonic feel to the strings. Each string is preceded with a dollar sign, then the string name, then equals, and then we have the actual string in quotes. If you want to include a binary string, we include those in brackets, and it's hex-encoded. And if we want to include a regular expression, we use the angle brackets. In this case, for our simple rule here, we're just going to use one string. And the string I'd like to use is what we call the run key in malware analysis. If you're not familiar with the run key, this is a registry key that a lot of malware uses to set persistence. When the system boots, any binary in this registry key will be started. It's like an auto runs. And a lot of malware uses this key, and because of this, a lot of malware has this string for the key embedded in it. Now you'll notice at the end of the string, I'm including ASCII and wide. This is because YARA by default assumes all strings are ASCII, but in our case, the string might be a wide string or it might be an ASCII string, so we're including both to make sure our rule covers both of those. So now we move down to the third part of the YARA rule, which is the condition. The condition tells the rule how to match the strings. So in this case, we just want to say if a file has this string in it, then it's a match. So we would just include the variable for the string. Now this is all we need to do to complete our rule. And if I save it out here and then run from the command line, you can see that it runs no problem, but we haven't found any files. So here I have a folder of malware that I've downloaded. These are just various malware samples. And if I run the rule again on that directory, you can see now we have a bunch of different matches. So that is basically what a YARA rule is. Now, of course, I've just touched on the very surface of what you can do with the rule. And there are many, many different types of string configurations and conditions that you can use in a rule. So below, I've linked to documentation for building rules. I find it quite intuitive. I write a lot of Python code and I find the syntax is very similar, but your mileage may vary. I also want to note that there are many shared YARA rules that are shared within our community through GitHub repositories or posts on Pastebin, etc. And when I was learning YARA, I found it very helpful to look at how other people had constructed YARA rules and steal ideas from them, or get some ideas for how I could use the format in new ways. So I've also linked below to a bunch of sample repositories that have open source YARA rules that you guys can go take a look at if you're interested in seeing how YARA is used in different ways. So that wraps it up for our introduction. Stay tuned for the next part. And like I mentioned before, if you enjoy this kind of content, go check out our Patreon. Lots more reverse engineering tutorials like this one right there. Go check it out. And until next time, keep exposing the mechanics behind malware. Like and subscribe. I don't know. Do we still do that? You guys let me know. All right. Bye, guys.